I just know that everything is, you're getting a lot. It's only the second day and it's just begun. And I know that your brains are like chopped meat already. So I'll give you a tiny break with something that I found. You see, you ask questions and suddenly you look at the newspaper, the science section, and there is an article about it. And I'll give you more than once. People often say, they call me before they come here, or they want lessons, and they say, am I too old for this? And I said, too old for what? Too old to learn, can you teach an old dog new tricks? That's very often the answer. And I say, in my experience and my colleagues who do this work, there's no difference. If the person is willing and flexible and wants to learn, they learn as well. So here is an interesting article, which is wonderful to know also, by Abigail Zuger, who's a doctor. And it's from the science section of the New York Times from May 29th, 07. And it says, the brain, malleable, capable, vulnerable. And it's very important to realize it in terms of all learning and brain damage also. And you know, when people come, by the way, with brain damage as in strokes and brain damage, the kind of damage that is done by injuries, because you're off, you can't go back. You have to find other ways. When we resolve things, there are new pathways that are formed in the brain. I'm not a neuroscientist, but I know that that's what happens, because it's a new behavior and it's a behavior that stays and sticks. So just quickly, I will read you a couple of paragraphs. In bookstores, the science aisle generally lies well away from the self-help section, with hard reality on one set of shelves and wishful thinking on the other. But Norman Doidge's fascinating synopsis of the current revolution in neuroscience straddles this gap. The age-old distinction between the brain and the mind is crumbling fast as the power of positive thinking finally gain scientific credibility. The credo of this revolution is neuroplasticity, the discovery that the human brain is as malleable as a lump of wet clay, not only in infancy, as scientists have long known, but well into hoary old age, like the rest of us. In classical neuroscience, the adult brain was considered an immutable machine as wonderfully precise as the clock in a locked case. Every part had a specific purpose, none could be replaced or repaired, and the machine was destined to tick in unchanging rhythm until its gears corroded with age. Now, sophisticated experimental techniques suggest that the brain is more like a Disney-ic? Animated sea creature, constantly oozing in various directions. It is apparently able to respond to injury with striking functional reorganization and can at times actually think itself into a new anatomic configuration in a kind of word-made flesh outcome far more characteristic of Lourdes, you know what Lourdes is, the miracle place, than the National Institute of Health. And if they come around, you know that there's really something to it. So it is forgivable that Dr. Doidge, a Canadian psychiatrist and award-winning science writer, recounts the accomplishments of the neuroplasticians, as he calls the neuroscientists involved in these new studies, with breathless reverence. The work is indeed mind-bending. Miracle-making, reality-busting stuff with implications, as Dr. Doidge notes, not only for individual patients with neurologic disease, but for all human beings, not to mention human culture, human learning, and human history. So it's really something incredible to know and to realize, and we know that because we see how people break through limitations, injuries, situations where they never thought they could come back, neither did medicine. And all this from the fact that the electronic circuits in a small lump of grayish tissue are perfectly accessible, it turns out, to any passing handyman with the right tools. So it goes on. So really, I would say that knowing that, but the right tools is really where it's at. Because you give it the wrong information, it's going to stay where it was. So just for you to know, there is no such thing as too old.